In this video, we will cover the administrative and setup actions that you'll need to complete in order to get up and running in your Rally environment. Most Rally environments require you to change your default password as soon as possible, so we'll start with that. If your company uses SSO to control sign-in, then this might not be relevant for you. To change your password, select the Setup link in the upper right corner and then select Edit Profile. Select the Actions menu, the ellipsis next to your email address at the top of your profile. Select Change Password from the options. In the pop-up window that appears, enter your new password and select Save. While you're here, you might also want to upload a profile picture and change your display name, both of which will be shown on the board view for work items that you own. Anytime you edit your profile, remember to confirm those changes by selecting Save. You can see what administrative permissions, if any, have been assigned to you by scrolling down on the Detail pane. These permissions can only be changed by your subscription admin, but none of them are required if you just need to create and edit work items. You can also select Permissions to view your complete list of permissions across every Rally project. Each project will show your status as either viewer, editor, or project admin. Your default project is the one that your environment will access if you don't manually select another from the project picker. This should be set to your team's main project, so it's worth checking to make sure. Session timeout defines the length of time that your logged-in session will last without the need to re-authenticate. You might need to adjust this to comply with company policy or some other imposed limitation, or set it to be as long as possible to save having to log in repeatedly. Configuring your notifications in Rally is an important aspect of making sure that you can work efficiently and see what needs your attention. On this Edit Profile page, the only option to configure notifications is the Email Notification Enabled checkbox. Provided that your subscription admin has enabled the option, ticking this checkbox will send you email copies of all your notifications. But how can you configure what you want to be notified of in the first place? For that, we need to go to Notification Rules. Here, you can see the default notifications available to all user profiles. These preset options cover the most common wide-range use cases, but they are all inactive at the moment. To test out the system, select the checkboxes to activate the default notifications. These templates will send notifications about every type of work item, but only those owned by you or directly related to items that you own, so you won't be overwhelmed immediately. This will allow you to test out notifications and get an idea of how they work. You can return to this page later once you have more experience to create custom notifications using the field, operator, and value conditions, such as this one, which will notify you when a work item becomes blocked and cannot be progressed further. If you have email notifications enabled, you will receive a notification email whenever one of these rules is triggered, but to see them in Rally itself, you need to add the Notifications app to your dashboard. Navigate to your dashboard, select the gear icon, and then select Add App. In the search field, type Notifications. The list of available apps will reduce to just one, the My Notifications app. Select Add, and it will be added to your dashboard. The app will display a chronological list of your notifications, giving you an at-a-glance overview of recent activity on your work items. Rally allows you to choose between three display configurations, which will affect how compressed or spaced out graphical elements will be in the UI. This option is present on most Rally pages, and you can switch between roomy, comfortable, or compact displays. For instance, roomy might be more helpful if you are screen sharing so that everyone can easily read the contents of a list or board, while compact can be helpful when you need to assess a large set of work items within one view. Now you understand how to set up your profile in Rally. To learn more about Rally and Agile practices, check out our blog and community. Like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you'll never miss new content as it's added.